Fran. I'm in my office, taking a bit of a departure from the usual stuff, because I've been wanting for a long time to do a video about this. Years, actually. My original idea of doing a video about playing blackjack was that I was going to hire a real professional blackjack dealer and, rent a real casino table and set it up and, do it all live and have multiple cameras showing the table and everything and have me talk about the strategy and what's going on with the game and everything. But, then the pandemic hit and, I really thought about it. It's like, well, there's really no point in doing all that. I mean, it would look good. Probably get a lot more hits on a video with a real dealer. But the simulation is exactly the same because in blackjack, and this is really what I love about blackjack, is that you have no opponents. Now, people are going to argue about this because people who love to play casino blackjack are, oh, Fran, no, it's about the table. It's about the table. It's about the people you're playing with. It's about teaming up against the dealer. Well, I don't do that. There are no opponents in blackjack. You're not playing against the dealer. You're not playing against anyone else. You're playing against the sheer odds of probability. And in the simulation, it's exactly the same as in the casino. We got 8 decks of cards and a shoe shuffled up all together. You're not allowed to touch the cards in the casino blackjack anymore, so it's no different than having virtual ones on the table. And the dealer doesn't have to be a person. The dealer can only do moves that are dictated by the cards. There's no decisions to be made by the dealer. If they get to 17, they gotta stop taking cards. If they haven't gotten to 17, they have to hit. They can't fold. They can't surrender. They can't double down. The dealer just has few things that they can do. But you as the player, you have the odds in your favor in a way because you have the ability to surrender and you have the ability to take a card. You can stop. You can stop at 16. You don't have to take a card. The dealer doesn't have that rule. They have to hit. So I'll explain some things while I'm playing, but I thought it'd be fun for me to play a game. Just me and the dealer. No crowd. Just one person at the table, it's just me. It's me against the cards. And the important thing to remember about blackjack is, there's no such thing as luck. There's no rabbit's feet, there's nothing, oh, you should do this, you should feel like this. No, it's just the sheer odds of probability. And because the dealer has to play the game the way the cards dictate, if you're playing perfect strategy, then the outcome of the game is already predetermined in the shoe. It's just a matter of riding the ebb of games as the hands go by, as you lose and win and lose and win. It's about curating the shoe by making the best decisions you can based on sheer probability. We'll talk about it as I play, but here's the simple game. I'm going to come to the table with $100, and in the old days you could play $5, $10 blackjack. That doesn't exist anymore. That's most casinos. It's a minimum of $20 per game. So we're going to play $25 a hand. I'm going to come to the table with 4 chips, and I'm going to play until I either double my money or I bust out. Okay, you ready? Let's play. $17 against a 4. Just gonna stand.
Okay.
4. All right, 12 against a 4. Perfect strategy says you should hit on a 12. And they got a 4, so chances are the dealer will likely not bust out if it pulls 2 cards. So we're going to hit on 12. Okay, now I have 13. I'm going to have to stand because if I pull another card, I'm probably going to bust.
Looking good.
and I let the dealer bust. Okay, we got a 10 against a 9. So now people would say, oh, you got a 10, you should double down on that. But no, you don't want to double down against a strong card. The dealer is a 9. If you double down, you get one more card, and that could be a 2. And the dealer just pulls a face card, and that's it. So now we're going to hit. We're not going to double down, but we're going to hit. We're going to take a card because we might have to take 2. So we're going to hit. All right, 19. We'll stand on that.
And a push.
That's a push. Push means you and the dealer have the same number. You get your bet back. Nobody wins. Okay. So we got 13 against a 10. So 13, 14, 12, 13, 14, it's a very gray area. You have three choices. You can surrender and lose half your bet without playing the hand. You can hit and pull another card, but you know, in those areas, you stand a good chance of busting out, maybe 50% chance. Or you could stand on it and wait for the dealer to bust. But the dealer has a 10, so the dealer is not going to bust out with one more card. So in this case, my perfect strategy, the best move, is just to surrender and hold out for a better hand. So that's what I'm going to do. And the dealer had a 20, so that would have been hard to beat. Okay, we got 12 again. 12 against a 13. So dealer's going to pull two more cards. Chances are they're not going to bust. We're going to have to play this hand. Or surrender. Perfect strategy says on 12, you take a hit. You take the chance. All right, there you go. So 18, we're going to stand on that.
Winner, nice going.
All right,
you
see.
Win?
Because when the dealer hits 17, they have to stop. They can't draw another card. So again, I'm playing perfect strategy, the long game. 9. Okay, 9 against a 4. Now some people say, oh, I got to double down on that, but no, I'm not going to double down. I mean, I could, but I'm not going to. I'm going to take a hit because, again, double down, you get one card. It could be a 2. So, you know, if it were 11 against a 4, yeah, I'd double down against that, but not a 9. So we're going to hit. 19, I'll stand on it.
Push. Better luck next time.
See? 2. Pair of 2s against a 5. Okay. It's a pair of 2s against a 5. Now, there's a few ways you could play this. I could split the 2s and play 2 hands, but I really don't want to play a pair of 2s. I don't want to play a 2 because the chance to pull a face card and then you're dealing with 12s. So I'm just going to hit on the 4. Okay, 14. It's even worse. But dealer's got a 5, so my best move is just to stand on the 14 and wait for the dealer to bust out, because they got to draw 2 more cards.
Looking good.
See? Perfect strategy. Against a 9. We're going to hit. Okay, so 17. It's a weak hand, but I really can't hit again. That's too aggressive. Strategy says stand on the weak 17.
That's it for me. Dealer busted.
Dealer busted out. Okay. That was just pure chance. It was a weak hand. The dealer could have very well have won. 14 against a 6. Okay, so if the dealer would have a strong card, have a 10 or a face card, I would just surrender and cut my losses. But dealer's got a 6, so highest probability of a dealer busting out. Dealer has to draw 2 more cards, so I'm going to stand, wait for the dealer to bust.
Loser. Sorry.
Okay, pulled an ace. So that was a soft 17. So, and you might say, oh, well, that shows that you should have surrendered. Well, no, because if you play 1,000 hands of blackjack, or many thousands, you know that the long game is, the probability is when the deal has a six, the probability, it's better than not that they'll bust. So the perfect strategy is to stand on it. Nine against a two. Okay. Nine against a two. I'm going to hit. Now, you could double down on a nine if the casino allows it. You could double down. But a nine I'm not confident enough in. It's not an 11. So, but we are going to hit. Okay. 18. Stand on it.
Feeling generous. What a winner.
Okay,
folks. Place your bets.
All right. So, I've doubled my money. So, I doubled my money. Could walk away. Could just take my $100 or $112.50 and walk away. But let's keep playing. Let's see how far we can go. See if we can get the pot up again. Could walk away. If it were an actual casino, I probably would walk away and just take my $112, but let's keep playing, see how far we can go. All right, pair of sevens against the jack. Okay, so pair of sevens, that's 14. That's a losing hand, but it's a pair. So really the best thing to do here is to split the sevens and play two hands against a jack. 17, a weak hand, but I'll stand on it. Another 17. So I got two weak hands as opposed to one guaranteed losing hand. So we'll stand on these two hands.
And a push.
Ah, see? Dealer has 17, double push. That's how you play a split. All right, now we got it. 11 against a two. You double down. One more card, but the odds are in our favor here for a good result. Not guaranteed, odds are in our favor. So let's double down on this 11.
Hey,
hey, see,
place.
That worked. Okay. Ace. Ah.
Blackjack, there we go.
Yes,
best
I'll
place.
Take it. Now, people might think that playing blackjack is about getting blackjack. If you get blackjack, you know, that's what you want to get blackjack. But honestly, in the game, very rarely do you get blackjack. It doesn't happen very often in real gameplay. If at anyone's sitting at a table, you're lucky if you get blackjack even once. Maybe twice if it's a longer game. But it's not the engine of winning. But it is nice if you do get blackjack, because, you know, you do get 3-2. So. But now, look at our pot. I'm up another 100. So now I have now tripled my money. So now that I've tripled my money, I want to keep playing, so I'll set a new bar, which means that I'm gonna keep 200 that I got. I'm gonna scoop off those 200. I'm not gonna bet on anymore. I'm just going to bet on the last $100, the last four chips. I'm going to bet on those, and if I lose them all out, I walk away with the 200. But we're only going to gamble with those four chips, so I'm guaranteed to walk away with at least double my money. But I'm going to gamble this extra 100 out of the winnings and keep going, see how far we can go. And that's how we play the game. You notice that I'm not upping my bet. I'm not putting down 100, I'm not putting all in. That's not how you play blackjack. That's not how you win at blackjack. You gotta play the long game. It's work. All right, a 16 against a seven. I got a 16 against a seven. The dealer just has to pull a face card or a 10, they win. 16, it's a losing hand. Perfect strategy is you surrender, cut your losses, you take half your bet back. So that's what I'm gonna do.
Okay, folks, place your bets.
Okay, 13 against an ace. It's a very bad hand to play. I could take a card, but I'd probably bust out. Ace is a very strong start. Dealer probably won't bust out. I'm gonna surrender two hands in a row.
Pay to play. Bet, please.
But rather than playing those hard hands, if you just surrender and, you know, wait for the hands, you can win.
Congratulations.
Twice in one table
win?
Sitting. See, you wait for the hands that you can win. Don't fight for every little hand, because very often than not, you'll have a losing hand. Ah! Ooh, very interesting. Double aces against an ace. So the dealer's got a very strong start on a hand here. They don't have blackjack, because if they have blackjack, they call it and it'll be over. So the dealer's got an ace facing, and we've got two aces. So we're going to split the aces, play two hands against the dealer's ace. Very high stakes, but we're going to do it. Split it.
Now
that happened very fast, but when you split aces, you get one card. It's like doubling down. But there you go. we won two hands, so those very fast. I should slow down the action on this simulation a little bit so you could see what happened there, but you can pause it. All right, 15 against a 4. Again, I'm not going to take a hit on a 15, but 4, it's 50-50. You could surrender it, you could stand on it. You could stand and wait for the dealer to bust. You could surrender and take the half. I'm up a lot of money, so I'm just going to stand on it. Dealer's got to pull two cards. If they pull a face card, they're almost certainly going to bust. Let's stand on it, see what happens. It's 50-50 coin toss. 50-50. They could have easily won, but it was a one or a, it was one move or the other. It's either surrender or stand. Again, this is exactly the same as playing in a casino. The gameplay is exactly the same. The shoe order is exactly the same. It's the same kind of random mix of 8 decks. It's exactly the same. Okay. So we got a 10 against a 10. I'm not going to double down because dealer's got a 10. That's a strong card. But I am going to hit. 15. So now we're... If I stand on it, I'm going to lose. I can't surrender. It's a bad choice, but I'm gonna take a long shot and hit it, because otherwise I'm just gonna lose. The dealer's not gonna bust. Okay, I took a chance. That was a long shot. I apparently had like a 30% chance of not busting out, but I took the chance. I won. So 18. We're gonna stand on it.
Player wins.
That's an example of winning by sheer chance. the odds were not with me. The odds were with the dealer very much there, but the odds swing either way. And look at our tally now. Now look at our tally. I'm up $300 plus $300, $312.50 up from where I started. So now I'm gonna set a new bar. So now I'm gonna set aside 300 in my vault, and I'm just gonna bet on the using the last $112.50. I'm just gonna use that money to put on the table. But I'm definitely gonna walk away. I'm gonna walk out with $300 either way. I've tripled my money, and I'm gonna leave with that. I'm not gonna gamble that money. This is the long game. And you notice I came with 4 chips. I'm still playing. And that is winning at blackjack. If you can stay in the game, stay at the table, and play, and I'm not spending any money. I'm not losing any money. I'm getting to play the game. And after those first 4 chips, I earned my time to continue to play. And I'm earning my time at the table. And that's really what winning at blackjack is all about. That and, of course, the money. But anyway, I'm going to keep going. Now, I should say, contrary, if you do lose, like I said, you set these levels as you play, and when you hit that level, you walk away. You know, that's it. You don't gamble at all. You don't just keep playing until you hit the bottom of the pot again. That's stupid. You're not playing the game. Are you playing the game or are you gambling? Are you playing blackjack or are you gambling? I don't gamble. There's no such thing as luck. There's no such thing as a streak. Doesn't exist. Playing the long game. I got a 15 against a queen. I'm gonna surrender.
Pay to play, bet.
Good hand. Stand.
Dealer busts. Time to make some money. You want to win? Gotta chip in.
All right.
Yes, please.
All right. We got a 10 against a 4. Could double down. I could double down on a 10. Take my chances that the deal's going to bust out. If the deal had a 6, I would. But I'm not going to be greedy. I'm just going to hit on it. 19. I'll stand.
Player loses. Try again.
See? Would have needed a much better hand than that. So if I would have doubled down, I would have lost twice. That's why you don't do it. Ah, okay. It's an 11 against an ace. Now, some people say, oh, you double down against that. But no, an ace is the strongest card that the dealer can have. There's no way the dealer's going to bust out taking another card. There's no way the dealer's going to bust out taking two more cards. It's the strongest position the dealer can have, and you don't want to double down because you get one card. I get a 2, there's no way I'm winning. And I'm losing double the bet. So no, I'm going to take a hit, just one hit. See, 16. Now I'm not going to win with 16 against an ace, so I have to hit again. I'm probably going to bust, but we're going to take the chance. It's the only way I can go.
Player loses.
There you go.
Can't play. Bet, please.
But that was... There's really no good way to go with that. Against an ace. You have to know what you're standing against. You have to know what the dealer's chances are versus your chances and make the decision based on that. And what the dealer holds is going to really have the strongest leverage over how you handle your hand. Now I've got a soft 19. I'm not going to take another card. Soft 19, will stand on it. Dealer's got a 5.
Dealer busts. Play away, money. Pay to play. Bet, please.
Here we go. Now we're back up again. Back up again. I'm back up to 300 up. Pair of 3s against a 4. You don't want to split 3s. Just take the 6. And I'll take a hit. All right. So we got an 11. We're going to hit again. Maybe get a face card. Get 21. Against a 4. Now the chance, if I could continue to hit, but the chances are if I take another card, I'm going to bust. And the dealer's got to pull 2 cards. So at this point, I've got a really bad hand. I'm just going to stand and see if the dealer will bust out.
Not this time.
Yeah, a bad hand, but it's this. It's the game goes like this. It's just a up and down and up and down like a graph. And whether you win or lose at blackjack, it's about curating the surf. You're surfing up and down. It's going up. It's going down. It's going up and down. You gotta know when to stop. You gotta know when to keep playing. And you curate that ride. But the game is already established in the shoe. You're just curating the game. That's what blackjack's all about. Okay. Still not down to, you know, I'm still gambling on the winnings, so until I get down to, these few chips, I'll just keep playing. Got a 20 against a 9, I'll stand on 20.
Yes,
got a
please.
Push. Another push. 2. Okay. That's a soft 13. We're gonna hit, obviously. Okay. So we got soft 20. I'll stand on it.
Dealer busts.
Alright. See, we're back up again. And you notice how long I'm playing? I came to the table with 4 chips. And I'm still playing. That's what it's all about. Okay. Perfect strategy. I got a 12, dealer has a 10. perfect strategy says you hit on that 12. You take the chance, you hit on the 12. That's what I'm going to do. Oh, 19, I'll stand.
Dealer busts. That makes money off. Right. You got to bet some to win some. Place your bets.
Still going. Oh! Blackjack.
There we go.
All right. I'll take it. Pushing up to another 100. 20 against an 18. I will take a 20. Stand on it. And we win. Okay. All right, see, that's the marker card. So we've reached the point in the shoe where we're going to reshuffle. So after we play this hand, we're going to reshuffle the shoe, and then the game's going to be completely different. If the game changes after the shoe shuffle to where the order of cards is really not in the favor of the game for me, I walk away. But shoe change. So, but I got a soft 16. We're going to hit on it. Okay. Soft 20. We're going to stand.
Dealer is out.
All right. And look where we are. I've crossed over another 100. So we're $412.50 up. I've earned a day's pay. So now I'm going to set a new rule. I'm going to play until I lose a hand. The next losing hand will be the end, and I walk away. Because I've pretty much, you know, I'm getting tired, and I've got plenty of winnings. So now it's like, okay, I'm just going to play a chip at a time. The next hand I lose, leave the table. And we got a new shoe. 8 against a 4, we're going to hit it. 10 against a 4, we're going to hit it. 14 against a 4. So could stand on it, but you know, I'm just going to hit. It's my last chip. I'm going to take a chance. For once, I'm not going to play a perfect strategy. I'm just going to take a chance, see if maybe I can get a 6 or a 7. Okay. 15. Well, I'm going to stand. If I take another card, I'm going to bust.
Dealer is out.
Okay, still playing. One chip at a time. Next hand I lose. 16 against a 10. Well, 16 against a 10, you surrender. But we're playing a chip at a time, so I'm not going to surrender. I'm actually going to do against perfect strategy, just for the shits and giggles, I'm going to hit on it. Chances are I'm going to bust out. But it's the last chip, and I'm going to leave the table. I'm going to hit on it. And that's why you don't hit on 16. And I'm out. That's it. That's it. So $412.50 is what I'm leaving the casino with. A day's earnings for one seat at the table. People are going to think, oh, Fran makes all of her money playing blackjack at the casino. Well, I hate casinos because, like I said, I don't gamble. I don't consider blackjack gambling because it's like any other puzzle. I'm working against the sheer odds and playing a perfect strategy. I'm not gambling. Well, you gamble the first $100. I'll give you that. And after that, you're just working to stay in the game. That's all it is. You know, I have considered like being a professional blackjack player, but when you come into a casino and if you win every day and every day you leave with like $400 or $500 in winnings, they don't let you play. It's like that you find when you come in the door that the security guards are just like, you're not coming in here. It's like, but I'm not counting cards, I'm just playing perfect strategy. It's like, well, you're not allowed to play perfect strategy. So, and they smoke in the casinos, so it's just, and the people, oh God, if you've ever been in a casino, it's like, it's the living dead. It's like the most, it, it's, it, It's purgatory. It's like hell. If you want to get a glimpse of what hell looks like, if hell could even possibly exist, just go to a casino. Look at the people there. That's what hell looks like. It's just a terrible place. And the people are it's just broken people smoking like chimneys. So, yes, I could go there and I could win $400 at a casino, but I don't want to be strong-armed and I don't want to deal with all that, so no. But I'm showing you how I play, so anyway, I've been wanting to do this video for a long time. Maybe someday, long after the pandemic, we'll do it with a live dealer or something, but at least I got a chance to show you how I recreate and play Perfect Strategy at Atlantic City Rules Blackjack. So, thanks to all the patrons down there on the Patreon for making these videos possible and, you know, hanging in there while my lab's all torn up and everything, you know. Be sure to stick around for the big holiday on the 25th. I'm going to be doing Lava Lamp Live again, so you have that to look forward to. And Happy New Year and all that stuff if I don't see you. Alright, I'm Fran. Bye!
I'm Fran.